everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the average value of a function over a given range. The function that we're given this time is f of x equals x squared, and we're asked to find the average value of that function between x equals negative 1 and x equals 1. So let's get to it. The formula that we're going to use is this formula here, and basically what it does is, ignoring the first part here, we're just going to take the integral on the range a to b, so it will get the area between the graph and the x-axis between negative 1 and 1, and then this part out front here is what helps us with our average value. So the first thing that we're going to do is go ahead and set up our integral. In other words, just plug everything in. So we're given the range a comma b here. A comes first, b comes second. So we plug in negative 1 for a and 1 for b. So obviously we're going to plug that in out here in front of the fraction and also as the limits of integration here. So we end up with 1 over 1 minus negative 1, and then we're integrating our function x squared from negative 1 to 1. So when we simplify that, we get a couple of things here. First of all, we end up with 1 over 2 because we have 1 minus a negative 1. So we have that 1 half in front. And then integrating x squared, of course, add 1 to the exponent. 2 plus 1 is 3. And then we divide the coefficient, which is 1, by the new exponent, 3. So we end up with a 1 third out in front and x cubed. And that's our integral, and so then we're going to turn this into a definite integral and integrate on the range negative 1 to 1. So now we go ahead and plug in our limits of integration, and remember with a definite integral, you plug in the top number first, so that's going to be 1 here, and then we'll subtract and then plug in the bottom number. So the 1 half stays out in front, and then you can see here we plug in 1, and then we subtract, and then we plug in negative 1. And those are always the steps you follow with definite integrals. So we plug those in, and now it's just a matter of simplification. So we still leave this 1 half out in front here. Of course, 1 cubed is just 1, so this first term becomes 1 third. And then negative 1 cubed is a negative 1, so we get 1 third times a negative 1. And because we have that double negative, with this negative here and the negative in between, this becomes a positive. And so we'll have 1 half times 2 thirds. And as you can see, the 2's are going to cancel, and our final answer will be 1 third. So 1 third is the average value of this function, f of x equals x squared, between the values negative 1 and 1. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!